Distal radius fractures, or wrist fractures, are seen very commonly in the United States. About 250 to 300,000 patients will fracture their wrist each year. Most occur either in children or the elderly, typically from a fall from standing position when they lose their balance and put their hand out to catch them. The wrist is composed of 8 bones of the carpus, as well as the 2 forearm bones. Typically, the larger of the 2 forearm bones is termed the distal radius, the most commonly fractured bone during a wrist fracture. When the patient falls and the hand hits the ground, the wrist is bent, and typically the bone will fail right over the top right here. In a more high-energy injury, oftentimes the hand and the wrist bones will impact into the larger bone and shatter it.
Because of the significant impact of a broken wrist on our lives, the most important step is prevention. Routine screening for osteoporosis and medical treatment, sometimes as simple as ensuring adequate daily intake of calcium and vitamin D, can prevent not only wrist fractures, but also hip and spine fragility fractures. If you or someone you know has fallen and you suspect a fracture, you should immobilize the wrist, then elevate it above heart level. Ice can help reduce the pain and swelling. If the wrist looks crooked or the pain persists, then it is important to seek medical care immediately.
You know, when you have a fracture of your wrist, whether it's displaced or not, it's important to see someone who's qualified in treatment of the full spectrum of wrist injuries, from simple to complex.
Hand surgeons are specialty trained to care for wrist fractures, and don't just take care of hands.
Hand surgeons have been the ones who have been on the forefront of innovation in fixing distal radius fractures for the last several decades.
In fact, most are experts not only of fracture care, but also care for injured nerves, stiff fingers, and other problems that may accompany a wrist injury. Fractures of the wrist that are allowed to heal in less than ideal position may lead to persistent pain and weakness. Treatment will depend on the age and activity level of the patient, as well as characteristics of the fracture, including the amount of displacement, joint involvement, and bone quality.
In an older patient who has a softer bone or there's more pieces of the bone due to the energy of the fracture, especially if a fracture is very displaced, it can be very hard for anything external like a cast to stabilize that fracture and maintain its position.
More complex fractures, which are too unstable for a cast to hold in position, are best treated with surgery. To have the best recovery after wrist fracture, it is important to control swelling and limit joint stiffness. Immediately after injury and surgery, keep your hand elevated above your heart. Maintain the motion in your shoulder, elbow, and fingers.
Recovery from a wrist fracture can take up to a year's period of time. With proper treatment, fractures typically heal within 6 weeks period of time, and then patients can start resuming normal activity and regaining strength at that point. If you'd like more information about wrist fractures or wrist fracture care, please go to the American Society for Surgery of the Hand's webpage at handcare.org.